My name is Jacob Biamonte, and I'm visiting the Institute for Quantum Computing at the University of Waterloo to teach a course entitled Quantum Techniques for Stochastic Mechanics. This course is actually all about applying quantum techniques to other areas of science, okay, such as biological and ecological systems. So the first thing that people ask me is they say, well, how could you apply quantum physics to something that isn't necessarily governed by quantum physics at the large scale? So a biological or ecological system, if you zoom in close enough, okay, the particles that make everything up, those things are governed by quantum physics. But if you look at this at the large scale, you see something complex. You see this emergence, new properties that emerge that not necessarily could actually be described by the same laws of physics that govern the small scale. In this emergent regime, these systems are extremely complex, okay? And there's a bunch of techniques to handle the complexity of these systems. Now, at the same time, we've spent so much effort trying to understand quantum physics and quantum computation and quantum information science. Extraordinarily sophisticated tools have been developed, okay? These two fields ultimately both address complexity and emergence and understanding very complex and complicated systems. So the point of the course is to put these two theories side by side, to make a shared mathematics, and to unite these things by looking at the similarities and differences. And through that unification, we can now apply techniques from either field to the other, and we're working on doing more of this. This is an emergent quantum technology that actually does not require anyone to build a quantum computer or a quantum information processing device, which is, of course, also going to be helpful for the environment because then we can solve difficult computational problems. But in this type of quantum technology, we're taking the quantum mathematics and we're applying that to systems that are not necessarily quantum mechanical. The contents of the course are all available on the internet. The book is available on the Azimuth Forum and the Azimuth Project, so you can check that out online. I'd like to thank the Institute for Quantum Computing for putting this on and for inviting me here to do this. And I'd like to thank you for watching. We invite your discussion, and we hope that you join the conversation. Thank you.